The year is 1155 Anno Domini. Bishop Henry, a holy man, gazing to the horizon as his ship slowly sailed towards the rocky coast of Finland. This godforsaken country lies somewhere west of Russia, where filthy pagans still roam the land, worshipping their false gods, practicing unholy rites, and living in sin.
Gonna be a fine day's day, my holiness.
Yes, indeed, my lord. We should be arriving at the shoreline any moment now. I can already picture the hordes of pagans running up and down the hill, just waiting to be baptized.
Should I order my soldiers to sharpen their swords, my holiness?
Yes, do that. And make sure my favorite choir boy, Jens, is waiting for me downstairs.
He needs to.
Attend to his singing.
Concentrate. Let your voice come out of you like a bed of flowers in June.
Pardon me, my holiness, but His Excellency told me to inform you that we are about to disembark. If you would be so kind as to follow me, I'll escort you to the deck.
Oh yes, of course.
Finland! Land of 1,000 pagans!
It's a land of opportunities.
For us!
And so Bishop Henry and King Eric slowly converted the people of Finland with the gentle guiding hand of a loving big brother to the civilized ways of Christianity.
Will you accept Jesus Christ as your personal savior?
Kautta Rutjan pukavaisen perän! En!
Well, then it looks like I must summon the Inquisitor! Inquisitor, do your stuff!
Now then, will you accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior?
Kautta ukko ylijumalan mahtavan falloksen, en!
Well, I guess then we have to get slightly messy around here.
Ei, enää tällaista! Jeesus, ota minut! Ei, Jeesus!
But then the day came when Bishop Henry's sinister crusade was put to an end. One day, he entered a dismal tavern called Pohjaton Kiljuvan. Beside him sat the ghastly Miss Kerttu, a woman in her early 40s who looked as if she had fallen down from a pine tree and hit every branch on the way. She was the wife of Lauer, keeper of the tavern.
What's your kind of a handsome holy hunk doing in a place like this?
Oh my god, what an ugly hag! Tell her to leave us alone!
Hänen pyhyytensä sanoo, että te varmaan olette enkeli, sillä mikään maallinen ei vedä vertoja teidän kauneudelle.
Oi kuka ihanaa!
What on earth is she looking at?
Saat
saata näyttää pikkuja enkeliltä, mutta sisälläni minua rinnu piru. Voisitko
ripittää minut?
She wants to confess.
Oh well, if I must. Come along then. Silence, woman! Your incomprehensible gibberish is blasphemy to my ears!
Kautta perkeleen! Kirjoa pöytään!
Kyllä, kyllä, heti!
Henrik kävi täällä, eikä hän maksanut.
Perkele!
Lolly should have known better than to meddle with the holy man, for his powers were far greater than Lolly could have ever conceived. When Lolly tried to remove the silver ring from his finger, it was stuck so tightly that it gripped his finger right of his hand. And as he removed the bishop's hat, he tore his scalp off his head. For the rest of his life, a horde of mice followed Lolly wherever he went, and he saw no other alternative than to commit suicide while drowning himself in a lake. And thus ended the tale of Lalli, a simple peasant who stood up against the tyranny of one evil bishop and the church behind these barbaric campaigns of war, which history refers to as the Crusades.
He told me to inform you that we are about to disembark. He would be so kind as to follow me. I'll escort you to the deck.
Okay.
Entä hyvä storia?
Noniin.
Sit paikka.
Noniin.
Nyt tuuli tulee ja viedä kaikki pois.
Ja sit tiputtakaa kaikki mun suun päällä. On.
Oh. Heittekää.
Tää tuntuu aika kivaa pakmaa.
No nyt se on ihan hyvä.
Kullot pois tietää, että olet kuoli.
Hei, pitää kiinnostaa vielä vaan kameraa.
Helvetti!
Läpi vaan sen vielä.
Kaane käsi näin.
Nyt ei se kirve siihen jää.
No nyt se on ihan hyvä.
Ei kun, ei sulla vielä.
Vittu, sitä.
Uuli.
Mmm.